The character of Momonosuke is increasingly becoming one of the most interesting parts of the current Wano arc. Whilst we've been watching his steady development to become a strong warrior like his father, when exactly will we see him live up to his name? And what exactly will this look like? Hello, my Nakamatachi, this is JoyGirl with a discussion of our favourite peach boy, Kozuki Momonosuke. Before we begin, I do need to warn anime-only fans that this video will involve discussion of content that the anime has not yet caught up on, so please feel free to watch some of my other videos and then return to this one at a later date. As for everyone else, I think for as long as I've been discussing One Piece on YouTube, I've said over and over again that I am waiting for Momo to step into his own and have his shining moment. And like I mentioned in the most recent chapter review, the sneaky yet steady focus on Momo in recent chapters has gotten me thinking for quite some time now, but particularly so after chapter 1008. So I think this is the perfect time to discuss this topic of Momo's role in Wano. Momonosuke's glorious moment has been hinted at for a very long time now, even before the Wano arc. And now that we're in the thick of the Onigashima raid, it's starting to feel like we will be seeing it soon. Especially considering how Oda has been sliding in Momo scenes to suggest bits and pieces of information relating to his devil fruit powers, not to mention the mysterious ability which we saw in chapter 1008. So this video is to expand on ideas that I have regarding what Momo's role will be in Wano and what we may be seeing from him in this arc, as well as what this may potentially mean for Momo post-Wano. A lot of my ideas I have been mentioning in some of my other previous videos, but not always to the level of detail that I think this topic deserves, so you will see me call back to a lot of these other discussions, which may feel like a lot of shameless plugs, but you don't need to go back to watch all of them, although you're more than welcome to if you feel like it. Anyways, starting with what Momo's role will be to save Wano. As I mentioned before in my chapter 997 review, I think Momo will be the one to stop Onigashima from landing on the Flower Capital. And there are a few ways or components to make this happen. Firstly, his devil fruit powers. As we know, Momo ate the artificial Zoan devil fruit created by Vegapunk using Kaido's lineage factor. However, ever since our introduction to the man-made fruit in Punk Hazard, it has been consistently called a failure. Which is interesting, as from what we have seen, it doesn't seem like Momo has consumed a defective devil fruit at all. The first question we need to ask, what makes Vegapunk, the inventor himself, consider this a failure? How would the scientist have known the fruit was a dud without seeing the aftermath of someone consuming it? In the case of the artificial smile devil fruits, only 10% of those who consumed them were granted Zoan abilities, with 90% of the fruits being duds. However, the only way through which someone is able to know whether one was defective or not is if it is consumed and seeing whether the eater was granted the abilities or not. Prior to actually eating the fruit and then seeing its effects, there seems to be no way to tell if one was a failure or not. Whilst the artificial smile devil fruits were created by Caesar Clown and not Vegapunk, I think the same logic would follow that unless the artificial fruit which Vegapunk created was eaten to be tested, he wouldn't know whether it was successful or not. The argument could be that the scientist created a number of these fruits using the exact same formula, and because all the others were defective, he could conclude that this one was as well. In which case, we would then also have to question, why then was this devil fruit saved and isolated in a secret room instead of being discarded? I mean, for something considered a failure, it seemed to be very precious in the way that it was being carefully stored in a glass case. Now, let's compare the effects of Momo's devil fruit to the other artificial devil fruits which we have seen. We don't know what a failed devil fruit created by Vegapunk looks like, and the only comparative model we can use are the smile devil fruits. But in this way, it seems like Oda has set some precedent as to what dud devil fruits are like. Those who consumed the defective smile devil fruits not only lost the ability to swim, but also the ability to express any negative emotions, only being able to smile or laugh despite their true feelings. Even amongst those who ate the successful smiles, their abilities are still differentiated from normal Zoans, as in the majority of cases, smile fruit users can only transform parts of their bodies rather than using the complete Zoan or hybrid forms. However, Momo does not display any of these side effects. He's able to transform into a full dragon, as well as possess additional abilities akin to that of dragons, such as the use of flame clouds. Perhaps the only way in which Momo's ability differs is the obviously smaller size of both his dragon form and his flame clouds, as well as the fact that unlike other Zoans who intentionally morph into their Zoan forms, Momo's transformation is instant and involuntary as they seem to be triggered by his emotions. In this way, Momo's artificial devil fruit could be considered a failure only if the aim was to create a devil fruit which is a complete replica to Kaido's devil fruit powers and would allow its user to rival the Yonko in size and strength. However, I think these limitations have more to do with Momo's inexperience than with the mechanics of the fruit itself. Rather than the fruit being defective, I think it could be attributed to the fact that Momo has only recently consumed the fruit and as a result, has not yet learned to control it. Not to mention that Momo almost had no prior knowledge as to what a devil fruit is or how they work. Think back to a younger Luffy whose inexperience and lack of prior awareness of devil fruits limited his ability to use his. Similar to Luffy, I believe that Momo's devil fruit powers can be improved through training. Because we see in chapter 1008 that Momo himself says that he is better able to control his devil fruit abilities than when he first met the Straw Hats. And here, I think this is how Yamato can be of use. Through his seeming knowledge of how dragon abilities work, Yamato can help Momo train and better utilize his devil fruit. In which case, if it is true that the only defect of this artificial fruit is that it has not yet reached its full potential to match Kaido's abilities, and this could be attributed to Momo's inexperience, then this is huge news for the Alliance. If Momonosuke, who has the blood of Kozuki Oden, is able to fully master the devil fruit modeled after Kaido, the strongest creature in the world, he would be a massive help to the Alliance, as Momo himself recognized in the latest chapter. And the fact that this was indeed mentioned seems to be hinting at what is to come. As to why Vegapunk would have deemed it a failure, well, that's another discussion entirely, which I do have some thoughts on and can be discussed at a later stage, particularly if we get more information as to where the genius scientist's morality lies. But for now, let's get back to Momonosuke. Because even if Momo harbors this great ability, there's still the fact that he isn't able to control it yet. In saying that, I can see how this may be resolved. In recent chapter reviews, I've been attempting to track where Momonosuke's group is heading. And though we haven't seen the mystery figure since chapter 1004, going by their last known location, the treasure repository, I think it's possible that we will soon see a run-in between Momonosuke's group and the mystery figure. Now, the layout of Onigashima and the Skull Dome is still a little hazy, so we can't say for sure, and please correct me if I'm wrong on this, but this is my understanding of some of the key locations for this discussion. The treasure repository is on the second floor, but external to the castle. We were also told that it is behind the tower, which seems to have been referring to the Right Brain Tower, in which case, we know that the Right Brain Tower is connected to the outside of the Skull Dome too. I've mentioned in my review of chapter 1006 that I think Momo's group is heading towards the entrance to go outside of the Skull Dome. And seeing as the mystery figure was no longer inside the treasure repository when the Scabbards woke up, unless they moved extremely quickly, it's also likely that they are now also outside. Which means that Momo will soon be running into the mystery figure. And why is this significant? Well, it's speculation at this point, but it does seem like it will be certainly significant, as in chapter 1008, the location of Momo's group is withheld from us, with Oda only labeling them as Momonosuke's group without telling us their location, which is strange considering we've been given this information in previous chapters. As to how this ties back to Momo's devil fruit powers, I think Momo will be soon running into his mother, Toki. As you already know, unless you are very new to this channel, I am a strong believer that Toki is alive. And if this is the case, and I am also correct about the locations of these two groups or individual, that will mean that Momo will soon be running into Toki. Considering that Momo's use of his devil fruit powers seem to be triggered by his emotions, I think having him reunite with his mother, whom he thought was dead, will be the perfect emotional trigger to him unlocking his potential as a Zoan dragon fruit user. Now, if not Toki, my next bet is that the mystery figure is Hiyori, in which case I think this will still work as Momo has also been separated from his sister for a long time, but the emotional weight is obviously more prominent if this was Toki, not to mention that Toki is my top candidate after all. Anyways, we have seen on more than one occasion that Momo holds the words of his mother close to his heart, that he is his great father's son, and that he will one day carry Wano on his shoulders. What if we see a moment where Toki reminds him of this once again, resulting in Momo literally carrying Onigashima on his flame clouds to save his country? Whilst this would be a beautifully poignant moment which I would just love to witness, I am still stuck with some reservations to do with Momo's strength. Though having the strength of his parents would no doubt bolster Momo's strength, we do have to be realistic. I mean, this is a whole island we're talking about here, which Momo would have to ensure it stays afloat. Kaido is the only one known to be able to do this, and he is the strongest creature in the world after all. In saying that, I can see some other factors coming into play so that we can resolve this. Which leads us to another of Momo's abilities, which has also come into focus in the recent chapter. The voice of all things. As I mentioned in the chapter 1008 review, I think that the comment Momo made revealing his knowledge of Luffy's current situation is linked to the voice of all things. Now, it's possible that Momo is using his observation haki as it was revealed in a Viver card that he is an observation haki user, but considering the suspense created due to this scene, I don't think the explanation for Momo's ability will be quite so simple. Another popular idea, which I read in the comments section, seems to be that this has to do with the connection between Momo and Kaido through the devil fruits. Which I do like the sound of, it certainly would fit the attention that Oda has drawn to Momo's comments, but I don't think that this is likely. If Momo is able to see things through Kaido's eyes due to sharing his lineage factor, it does make me wonder why he hasn't been able to see other moments. For example, when we find out that Onigashima is being lifted up by Kaido, Momo asks Yamato what is happening, rather than seeing for himself what Kaido is doing. This same reasoning could be considered to suppose that Luffy also having the ability to hear the voice of all things means that he and Momo are able to communicate to each other. Again, I think that this is unlikely because it does then beg the question of why they didn't use this ability earlier. In saying that, my idea as to how Momo can sense Luffy does have to do with the voice of all things, as I've mentioned previously. And I won't be getting into the discussion of whether this ability is another advanced stage of the observation haki, though it is possible, the fact that we already have future sight makes me think that this isn't very likely. Anyways, whether it's a specialized form of haki or not, it still means that Momo is able to sense Luffy through the voice of all things, which is what I want to focus on. As we know, the voice of all things is the ability to hear the voices of inanimate objects and animals who aren't able to speak the human language. What is particularly interesting is that of all those known to hear the voice of all things, it seems Momo holds the greatest ability over it. Aside from Shirahoshi, whose ability to communicate to the Sea Kings seems also to be a case of her being able to perceive the voice of all things, Momo was the only other character, and the only human, able to converse with another creature using this ability. Whilst Luffy is also able to hear the tormented cries of the ancient elephant Zunisha, he says that it won't listen to him. And indeed, it was Momo's order which Zunisha listened to. What is more, it also seems that Momo was not only able to hear Zunisha, but was also able to make use of the elephant's sight and could see through Zunisha's eyes to witness Jack attacking Zoro. Something which we haven't seen on any other occasion related to the voice of all things. On top of the fact that Momo seems to be most in tune with this ability, we also know that he stayed behind at Zoro to speak with Zunisha further, partly to find out more about the voice of all things. Meaning that Momonosuke may have learned how to better use this power. In chapter 1008, he says that he is better able to control his devil fruit. Who's to say that he hasn't also improved his ability to sense the voice of all things? As we know that this ability can also be used to hear inanimate objects such as poneglyphs. So, is it then possible that Momo is using the voice of all things to communicate with the Onigashima skull? All the objects or animals we have seen this ability used with have a recurring theme, in that they're all related to the mystery of the previous ancient world. Onigashima would fit quite well into this theme when we consider the giant skull and the sword which marks the mysterious island. Furthermore, the skull seems to resemble the shape of the head of ancient giants when we consider its size, but most importantly, its horns. As we know, Oz died 500 years ago, and knowing that giants have a much greater lifespan than humans, it seems that ancient giants likely existed before and around the time of the Void Century. In this way, it seems that Onigashima and the mystery of that giant skull is likely also connected to this period, meaning that it seems very possible that Momo would be able to hear the voice of the Onigashima skull, which is how he is able to know of Luffy's current circumstances. Also, I think it's possible that the skull's voice became louder as the battle on top of the rooftop intensified and Momo climbed higher inside the castle, thereby getting closer to the brains of the castle. We've seen this before in Zoro, where the closer Momo got to the whale tree, the louder the voice became. And if it is the case that Momo is able to hear the Onigashima skull, I think that this will be taken a step further and we will see Momo use his ability to talk back and actually give orders. More specifically, orders to keep the island afloat and prevent it from dropping onto Wano. We do have a little problem here in that, at Zoro, Momo was speaking to Zenisha, a living being who is able to take action, whereas here, we're dealing with an inanimate object. However, I don't think this renders the possibility impossible. I can picture a similar moment to Fishman Island, where Shirahoshi's cries were able to command the Sea Kings to pull the Noah from falling. In Wano, Momo would be able to use the voice of all things to communicate with some other creatures to help him keep the island afloat. At this point, it isn't too clear what these other creatures could be, without the candidates getting pretty wild. For example, the mountain god, which we saw in Odin's flashback, could come back into play here and being a massive creature considered a deity, it could help shoulder the weight of the island from falling. And personally, I quite like this idea because then this would have the mountain god go from a creature that set out to destroy the Flower Capital to an ally that would actually save Flower Capital from destruction. It could even be the now fully grown Koyama, or maybe even both parent and child. We also have the Numbers, who are admittedly in Kaido's crew, but we could see that they come under the control of Momo and the Alliance, although as we haven't seen anything to suggest this yet, this possibility does seem quite unlikely at this point. Or, considering that the island itself seems to be a very mysterious and sacred element, perhaps Momo can talk directly to Onigashima. And if we were to get really crazy, which you do know that I enjoy, we could consider the skull of Onigashima, which looks similar to that of an ancient giant's head. In my video regarding the possible candidates for the Odin figure of chapter 1007, I discussed the significance of the sacred tree at Onigashima, which are known to house spirits in the Shinto religion. And whilst this didn't come into play regarding the Odin mystery, perhaps it could come into play somewhere in this arc. What we could have is the spirit of an ancient giant, which was being held by the sacred tree, now free after the tree was cut down. And so, Momo may even be able to command an ancient giant to help keep Onigashima afloat. However, as I discussed in that Odin video, I'm not too keen on the idea of spirits coming into play in One Piece. Anyways, whatever it is, whilst in previous predictions I've said that Momo would be keeping this island afloat through the use of his flame clouds, what if he can make use of the voice of all things to do so, or maybe a combination of both? I think this would be a really cool way for Oda to tie up a lot of things together. The payoff in setting Momo up to have an awesome moment, as well as the mystery surrounding his artificial devil fruit, whilst also making use of the voice of all things, which could even shed some light as to how Onigashima originated. Also, if we were to focus on the voice of all things for a little longer, I think Momo making use of this ability could even affect his future character arc following Wano. Because I think this would increase the chances of him leaving Wano to make further use of this ability. In the video where I discussed the potential of a new Straw Hat member at the end of the Wano arc, I discussed how Momo could be a candidate as even though I don't think it's super likely, it still wouldn't be completely off the table because he could leave Hiyori to lead Wano, seeing as she's more age appropriate. However, even if Momo doesn't join the Straw Hats and he does stay behind at Wano, this would be a very handy ability to have once he became a shogun. Imagine if no one has to report anything to him, and he's already able to know everything that's happening through the voice of all things instead. I'm sure after this arc, Wano will become a location of interest for many different groups, perhaps most notably the world government, and having this ability and Momo's proficient use of it would be very useful. But that brings us to the end of this discussion. Thank you for listening to my thoughts on the topic, and please let me know where you think Momo's character arc will take him in Wano by leaving a comment below. Please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already so that you can keep notified of any other discussions we have about One Piece. This is JoyGirl, and I'll see you again soon.